Hello, and welcome back to the Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, and today we're going to be taking on a side quest, the one that we activated in the last episode, the Ceremonial Song. Now this is something I've not done, so I have no idea where the heck it is, but if we look at our map, and actually go to the map, it seems to be over here, so can't be that far away, right? Like, so we just hop, skip, and a jump along a bridgeway. Don't really know if I'm on the right floor for it. It seems to be more up than anywhere else, so let's just go upstairs, I guess, and look for it. Probably just gonna have to jump over here, then up onto this floor. Just looking over there, thinking, is that like a chest? But it's not. So he's not, like, he doesn't hate us anymore, it seems, which is good. It's always nice not to be hated for no reason. So we have another spot to go ahead and find it. After talking to him, seems to be further up here, regardless. So hopefully when we approach this area over here, we'll be able to find it. Or at least find the dot to do with it. Apparently dropped that off a bridge, but like, who knows? Like, if I go back to the adventure log here, so recreate the spear, I guess. Even though we have the normal one, the light scale trident, I doubt this one will work. Nothing really to do with this, it seems. He dropped it off a bridge, though. Where could it possibly be? There's that bridge here, which, again, it could be anywhere around here. He didn't specify what bridge it is, he just said a bridge. Or the bridge. Like, what bridge are you talking about, bro? Nothing up here. This looks suspicious. Alright, it's a chest, but I have to... I have to pull it out. With magnesis, preferably. Can I not get a lock in it from here? Too far away? Alright, we're gonna need to use the freezing ability to, first of all, make a platform for us to go on top of. From here. Alright, this is going to be a little bit more problematic than I had hoped. There we go. Now from here, we're gonna use Magnesis to pull the chest out. Just fine, just kick this open. And it's a bow that I generally didn't really want. It's another one of these FPS bows. Already have one. Like, one's enough. Nothing. It has to be somewhere. Like, the bridge is right there, right? So. Weld life and stuff here. There's a rock, which means the Korok is here. Just have to find the rock. There it is. And complete a circle. It's not even complete, but I'll take it. Very big leniency window there. Not getting anything from my sensor from looking for the trident. I'm guessing it's just not here. I have no arrows to kill it up with. I probably do have normal ones. Yeah, it was just on the skill instead. Or the shock arrows, I should say. Again, I don't think there's anything particularly down here, I'm just making sure that there isn't. I don't get it. I'm just to follow it. I can't really see another way around it other than following it. I'm guessing I have to blow this up though. Yep. Quite destructible anyway. Is it stuck? Well, I can't really move it without blowing it up, so... Killed a cart by accident. Interesting little side quest, though, to follow this. Nobody here. This is some crap if there's nobody here. Oh, there is. There's someone. So didn't update our quest until, you know, we've done that. But do I have a claymore? To open up this stuff instead. It's nice that that actually did end up being something and not just a load of crap. Okay, so now I'm gonna warp up there. That took so much of my time to get that right. But I'm going to warp up there and I think meet him. I don't know what a helmet is for Visor armor, but we're gonna have to find it at some point. Problem with like tracking this stuff down, it's gonna be hard to do so. This is a bit bad, so I don't want to sleep. I wonder if we can talk to him and see if he can help us find it. So you can still sense that it's here. I have to go find it. So here's the end of my quest. It's kind of creepy because I picture Visora to still be a child. I don't really know how to interpret it all that, but it's Nintendo, I guess. It's kind of worrisome. Alright, okay, she doesn't have a side quest. I thought she did for a second. Where's that guy? That Zora. Okay, so it turns out I'm an idiot, and I know where it is now. If we come over here and use our magnet, there it is, the trident. So now I need to freeze the water to be able to lift it up. Mainly because the trident itself is actually further out than I thought. In the water again, I have to lift it up. Annoying. Come on. No? Alright, fine. We'll destroy all of these and go and move it slightly. Where is the magnet? There. Lift it up. Place it down. No, fair. Okay. I can't hold it. How do I take it off? Or how do I replace it with? I have a focal bat that I don't want. And ceremonial trident. There we go. Now from here, I was going to say ride a waterfall, but I don't see any around to actually ride one. There's one right there, actually. Let's head over this direction, if I can get over here. Doesn't appear like I'm going to be able to, judging by the amount of stamina I have left here. Yeah, I drowned. Must be a waterfall behind me anyway in Zora's Domain. Yeah, there is. Just to make her way out of here. have to let my stamina fully recover. And dash over here, and we're gonna use the bridge and go up to where the shrine would be. That was the stupidest thing I've ever seen. I just had to not touch the analog stick to make it pop up. I like killed myself a few times trying that. Like, I depleted my hearts essentially by trying that, and it was pretty frustrating. I just have to paraglide and then do it, and it was a different attack stasis from where I was. But this is complete now, thankfully. We completed 2 side quests in one go, one of which was like a non kind of required for 100% completion or whatever, but it's still a side quest. So as you can see, my elephant is gone for the time being because I jumped off and I killed myself with it. But the elephant recharges in 30 minutes, so it'll be fine. Oh, it's a straight up, walk up and grab your stuff and leave sort of situation. Silver rupee, wow, it's so great, thank you very much, I suppose. Kinda saddened that it was only a silver rupee after all that work, like, I thought the reward would have been greater. Let's get this one, and we have the spirit orb. Yeah, I could have used those hearts when I, you know, like, basically killed myself trying to open up this place. Alright, there is a marker. But I want to go through, well, I want to set a marker for something, and it's way up here. No, I just want to set a pin, but, well, we're going to set a pin here. And that pin is going to be pretty much where I'm going to aim for, so I'm going to go up to that waterfall right there and go up it to Toto Lake. And the reason why is because that is apparently where the helmet is, according to my friend that also found the helmet, and I did not. So we're going to go get the helmet. As you can see in the top left of my screen, the elephant is charging. It will begin to fill up over time, and then Mipha will tell us when it's ready to be used. But for now, it is unusable, and if I die, I am on my own. Then up here, meant for waterfall link. Alright, if he doesn't curl around and come back to us, then I'm not chasing him. Forget him. So, what's Fangvis? I think it's right there. There we go. Zora Helm. So from here we can actually use this to basically complete our armor set for the Zora. Which is pretty good now. Like, I have no idea how fast it'll be. It barely drains any stamina though. And it's actually really fast in comparison. That's so good. Like, that's gonna be so helpful for just oceans in general, where I'm not gonna drown anymore. That's what was Alphos. I don't think there's anything on top of here, but I mean, like, these places are always worth checking because it could be anything. I'm sure there's probably Koroks and stuff around here, but I don't wanna look around too much, I guess, right a second. I came up here for this hat, and that was it, really. This thing is probably worth checking out, though. Luminous Stone. Remember that guy, like, asked for more Luminous Stone? Well, we can go give it to him now. I can fight out with Zalphos really fast as well. There we go, he's dead. Kinda just wanna go higher in case there's like stuff up here. Oh, this alpha has just been weird. In case there's a shrine or something nearby. I think I mapped my thing back to shrines. Yeah, I did. Okay. So it's not gonna... It'll beep at me if, like, I'm near one, but right now it doesn't seem so. I just realized how to hunt Koroks. I am an idiot. I can use the thing to hunt for Koroks. I'm so stupid. How did I not think of this before? It's so obvious, I just need to take a picture of a stupid Korok, and then, like, we're good. We can hunt for Koroks. We shall just fly down here and think more on our stupidity. On my stupidity, really. You're up the back. This is something I want to do later, but this is not the thing that I want. Just noticed that he had a thing above him as well, though. He is above me. He is not on this floor. I just realized this. How annoying. I think he is. Is it you that I have to talk to? I have to find this guy. I don't know where the hell he is. We got a diamond, so that's worth 500 rupees. Oh my god, 1,000 rupees. Okay, that was definitely worth. Alright, that's that complete. We have other side quests in this area, however. Wine on Safari, we have the Hinos stuff, the Giant on Varelis Pond is one that we can do. Slate for upgrades is stuff that we can do later. Robbie's Research, etc. is also. The Giant on Varelis Pond is not one we're going to do right a second. The Zorastone Monuments, we have to find all monuments in the Zorastone. We'll find that later. A wife washed away. Let's find her. Where could she possibly be? Let's look at the map, actually. Where is she in Spill? She is. There's a guy right over here. Well, he was upstairs, actually. We can buy more food now, I guess.
Yeah.
I'll take them all.
Hi. Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. Hi. Yeah.
We're also gonna sell the two diamonds that we just got. Right here. So, 1,000 rupees for that. We have more luminous stone that we can sell. I'm gonna keep one in my inventory for later. You'll understand why when we get here. Alright, so we're back at the top near Toto Lake where we got the Zora helmet over there originally. I need a point of view to basically see where the hell we're going up here because it's an unexplored area of the map. That guy will probably attack us. Is he coming after me or not? Well, he's not really interested apparently. Don't care to kill the birds right a second. I have another objective. I hear a Korok. Oh. It's a glow, but it's faint because of the light. Yeah. There's the Korok. So this is something I was gonna abuse before. Or not abuse, but do it right. Oh, come on. Come on, that's evil. I can't analyze him. It doesn't work. I thought I figured it out. I thought I understood how to track him. But it doesn't care. It doesn't even want to analyze him as a Korok. I could have done anything to make it work, but no. Just look, I can picture this as being a fox, probably, if I actually zoomed in on it. Made it work, and it disappeared into existence, but yeah. That's annoying. You can't do it with a Korok. I guess that'd be too easy, right? Like, they don't want it to be that easy, but you can just go Korok hunting. But, oh, it's frustrating. There's a shrine down there. The right stick. So, place a pin. I don't see any up there. Just in case. Before I go jumping off into what appears to be a world of hell. Yeah, it doesn't seem like there's much here. There's a Zora Tower. Wait, is that the tower that we were on before, though? It looks different. This might be a different tower entirely. In which case, we are probably going to be good to go from there if Link didn't just, you know, plummet all the way back down. Actually, we're just going to, like, go and go up the waterfall. Oh my god, he can dash, like, properly. I did not realize. Just by doing a dash attack. Appears to be something over there. Like a search system or something. Either way, it's weird. What the hell is that?
Mipha's grace is ready.
Scared the crap out of me, Mipha. What the hell? I have no idea what that is, but it looks like trouble, and I don't want to deal with it. Ah, crap. It's gonna find me, isn't it? It looks like a guardian of sorts. Flying little guardian, right enough, but a guardian nonetheless. It probably has a laser beam. I hear Book of Winds. And a dead guardian. Just an ember. You look strong, and that did a lot of damage, I just realized. Ah, god. Best armor, I guess, is what we're gonna have to do for now. And probably a better weapon than what we're currently wielding. Probably a good idea too. The light skill trident. I need food of some form. We'll have to do for now. Come on, die, die, die. Alright, he's dead. I did quite a bit. Alright, he's dead now. What if he's even spiked Moblin Spear? It's not really worth it, but it felt like quite a lot, like honestly, but it didn't. Dragon Bone Bokoblo. Like, it's still a pretty strong weapon. Whatever. Oh no. No, dude. It can fly, this is bullshit. Hear mallets? What the fuck? There's mallets everywhere. How am I gonna get on this tower, dude? Where's my bombs? I don't know what that was. Money, by the sound of it. But where it is, who knows? It probably is in the mail. It's great. What the hell? The mob one's killing himself. Oh, whatever. Well, I'm glad I witnessed that. Like, he died, essentially. There's malice everywhere on this place. I don't really know how I'm going to uncover it right this second. I need to find the eye, the source. Either way, it's disgusting and covered in mallets. There has to be a way to it from here. Oh, he has a nice arrow. I keep falling down. He's in the malice. He can touch it. I can't. There. How am I gonna get past the mallets? I, to be honest, don't really see a way past the Link. Oh, God. Yeah, it's blocking it from all around. There's the eye, though. It didn't get rid of all of it. It didn't even get rid of any. There must be more. More eyes, more sources. I mean, it's still gurgling, so there must be more kicking around. It's difficult when you can't actually spot it. None lying around here, anyway. There's another shrine down here, though. Holy crap. Oh god, that's alive. That's not a sensor bar. I do not need to know anything more about that guardian. I do not want to fight it at this point in time. I'm trying to find the balance source to shut the malice off entirely. It has to be around here. What? Where is a Bokoblin in this place? I don't know where the eye source could possibly be. That's just glow from the towers. Nothing special. Unless it wants me to fly over here, kill this idiot. Whilst he's down, and take all of his guts, and take the night shield from him. I need to heal though. We are gonna eat simmered fruit, I guess, or we'll eat this. I need to drop something. Goodbye, ice rod, I suppose, or boomerang. The boomerang is like whatever. I don't really care about it. And then the shield. Drop the silver one. I killed one of the eyes. Surely it would have done something, but apparently no. Can't grip that. Can't stand up here either. I feel like it does want me to do this. Upside down. I feel like this is what it wanted me to do to get to here. To get up here. I have fruit of some form, don't I? Like heat resistant stuff. I don't know where it is, but it's somewhere. There we go. I found some. That's one that I've done, or marked, I should say. Alright, I made it up. Why do I get a feeling you're alive? At least I can come back here at any given time now. What a weird shot to show me. Like, it's not the full scale. The map looked really weird there. So this is Alkella. Okay, this is different to what I was expecting it to be, but we can work with this, sort of, I guess, for now. There's a pen over there and a pen over here, so, and one way over here that I set out from before. So we can go in different directions now. Let's check this guardian. He looks broken. Just an ancient screw. Thank God it's not alive. I don't like the airborne ones. They freak me out. Aerial guardians. We're gonna go to that shrine over here. This one might take me a while to fly to, actually, just kind of looking around. I should be alright though. Like nothing horrible. Take this like weird looking clothing off for the time being. Climber set, since we're probably gonna climb soon. Don't know if I'm gonna make this, but the wind seems to not be working with me. Oh my god. Please don't tell me both of them. Oh, they are. I don't want to drop. I will die if I drop. I have stamina food. We are taking a bite of stamina food. This one looks like it's the crappiest of them. Yeah, we have stamina food, and this one looks like it's the crappiest, so we're just going to consume that for the time being. I need more stamina wheel. That's like the next upgrade, I think. I'm not a fan of going down there to fight them right now. That looks like something, though. Looks like a golf course. A big hole in the middle. Alright, a shrine. I think this will be the last thing we do in the video. We have done quite a lot at this point. My hands are going numb because I need to turn the heating on. Major test of strength, please, please no. Minor, thank God. Okay, we can probably do this one then. It's a minor test of strength, but it is probably fine to fight this one. We have a ton of ice arrows. We have a weapon that'll probably wreck it, but we also have this that'll stun it temporarily. We'll go with this for the time being, and if it doesn't work out, then that's fine. Equipping better armor for now, until we upgrade this crap at some point. Then we have, like, we have free fairies, should be right, and good food. Where is the... I don't want a hasty elixir. I'm after, like, attack preferably. attack. Wow, that's an increase. Have we got anything better here for attack? Apparently no. Apparently that. Oh wait, I'm stupid. I have rice balls. And V. 3:50. Triple attack.
Should be able to make use of this.
Just a minor test of strength. Nothing too severe. Let's go. Ah, we can't freeze it. I thought maybe because it's a robot. But I could freeze it. I guess that didn't work, even though I dodged because I got stuck there. That was weird. I just destroyed it, wow. I didn't even need the attack boost. Well, maybe I did. Like, maybe that's why I destroyed it, is by having the attack boost. Ancient battle axe, you are definitely worth, and I should drop something for you. Goodbye, Ace Rod. But we should be okay, hopefully. Hopefully this has something decent in it. Giant ancient core. Wow. I never read the description because I'm an idiot. So where is it? It's like at the end, giant ancient core. All right, okay. So I guess we'll find out what it actually does later. I'm sure it upgrades a different stasis or state ability or something. But that's 3 orbs. And that's probably gonna be it for this video. I've done a lot in this particular video. And I'm gonna have to edit a lot of it then, and it'll be a bit of a pain in the ass, so I think that's pretty much going to be it when the game loads. So, I'm going to say thank you very much for watching, and see you guys next time on The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, I was going to say Twilight Princess, when we explore a bit more, do a bit more shrines and stuff, hopefully, before continuing to the next area in the game. We're still exploring this area, because that's a great fairy. We're going, like, I don't care that it's the end of the episode, we're going over here. This is a great fairy. We are making use of this. Hello, great fairy. Carrots and such. I was hoping there'd be actual just small fairies kicking around, but it doesn't seem so. These flowers must be worth something. That's why I'm picking them up. And I'm guessing this stuff here is probably going to be helpful, probably for upgrading my ability. These are not pickable flowers. Okay. Yeah, we should be good to talk to her. Hopefully it's not going to cost a ridiculous amount of money. It's the same stuff as before. This one's Mija. 500, Jesus. Alright, okay. So she can enhance stuff. What am I missing? Shard of... I don't know what that is, but I can't upgrade it. What about this stuff? Wow. This stuff can be upgraded, and it probably should be upgraded, to be honest. This can also be upgraded. You're gonna upgrade this. Enhance away to the highway treasures, I guess. Oh. And the hood, since we can upgrade this also. What is Hightail Wizard? Yeah, I don't have that many of these. I have none. But it's good to know, you know, that I can enhance this. Cannot enhance for these three. Moblin Guts is what I'm missing for this. So I need more Moblin Guts and Keese Eyeballs to upgrade all of these. But we can upgrade this Aura Armor. Then upgrade this one as well. That's everything we can do for now, but yeah, that's going to be it for this episode, so thank you very much for watching, and see you guys next time on The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild.